Joining us now is our friend, best-selling author, latest one, Spring Fever, former assistant U.S. attorney for Southern District of New York, federal prosecutor. You read him at National Review and PJ Media and everywhere else, and he was just on Fox. Andy McCarthy, that's why he's wearing a tie, folks. Hello, Andy.
Hey, Steve, how are you?
So you wear the tie for Fox, but not for us. That's okay.
Because you don't demand a tie. You don't have a dress code.
Right. That's true. We're a non-tie show. I'm the only one who wears a tie. Anyway, I don't even know where to start. And I know you know how many scandals there are. I got two things for you that have nothing to do with IRS or Benghazi or AP stories. First of all, a second appeals court has joined with the D.C. Circuit Court in ruling that Barack Obama's recess appointments to the NLRB unconstitutional. So that's more reinforcement that this guy is in it up to his eyeballs on every level. Now, I want to switch gears and get your take on this. And I teased this before we went to the break. The Boston bomber, the little brother, the innocent one, he had a note. He wrote kind of a little mini manifesto, if that's possible, that they found on the boat when they captured him, talking about how they did what they did because if you kill one Muslim, you hurt all Muslims, and they were avenging all the hurt that the U.S. put on Muslims in Afghanistan and Iraq, and that he's not mourning for his brother because his brother is a martyr who went to paradise. So don't tell me this isn't hardcore Islamic radicalism.
Steve, this has reminded me from the beginning, all this talk about how he was led around by his Bengali brother, of what used to happen in terrorism cases, and in particular in the terrorism case I tried many years ago, where in the part of the plot that dealt with blowing up targets in New York City, we had an informant into the plot. So all the fellas, of course, said that they weren't really jihadists. They were kind of gulled into it by the informant.
Right.
And I asked the jury at the end of the case, you know, just think about it for a second, common sense, logic, whatever. What would someone have to do to induce you to commit indiscriminate mass homicide? And, you know, the fact of the matter is, people don't get led into that or gulled into it by some other person. They commit these heinous acts because they are in the grip of an ideology which is very, very powerful and has been causing people to commit these kind of acts for about 14 centuries.
Right. No, absolutely. And not only does the note show that, in my opinion, that he was, you know, very much involved in this, but and you know, even if you harm one Muslim, you hurt all Muslims, that's separate. But to me, the part that shows, you know, this what some people would call the warped view of Islam, what some people would say is a strict interpretation of the Quran, what others would describe as Islamic radicalism or fundamentalism, was the part where he's not mourning for his brother because his brother's a martyr who went to paradise. Probably, I don't know if he left out the virgins part or not, but that shows to me what is the root of our problem in this country and the West's problem, which is radical Islamic fundamentalism, where people think they're doing God's will by blowing themselves up.
Yeah,
or killing people. Yeah,
that's the overarching problem, and the immediate problem, which is a very big part of that, is that the Muslim Brotherhood strategy, and the Muslim Brotherhood works closely with jihadist groups. People shouldn't believe the nonsense that you know, gets spouted that they're anti-terrorism. Remember, this is the Muslim Brotherhood whose Palestinian branch is Hamas, right?
Yeah, John Brennan was the one who put that forth, wasn't he, or one of the winners?
He's one of them, right? But the point is that their strategy in the West is something that I've called voluntary apartheid. I don't think that I'm hardly the first person to come up with that. But the idea is, they want to establish these enclaves in the West where basically Muslims move in and they get encouraged to integrate but not assimilate. And they have the kind of insulation and encouragement of each other, and they can stew in this ideology without really, you know, Western principles breaking in. And I think a big part of the problem that we have here is between the intimidation of these Muslim Brotherhood front groups that have made Islamophobia, this thing they've concocted,
right,
the equivalent of racism, so that people are afraid to speak out, and setting up these enclaves where, you know, this ideology is freely bantered about and nobody really can either confront it or refute it. is giving a comfort level to people like Dzhokhar Tsarnaev to get steeped in this.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Andy, let's move on quickly to something else. Let's focus on the IRS scandal for a second. Attorney General Holder was questioned yesterday, and we played the compilation of him. I don't know. No, I don't know that. I didn't know that. I don't know that. But he was asked specifically, when did you recuse yourself from this case? And he couldn't give a date. And they pressed him and said, didn't you write it down? When you recuse yourself, don't you write it down? Isn't it noted? Is there some record of it? No. Who'd you tell? Well, I told my assistant. No, you know. Well, did he write? No. Didn't you think it would be a good idea to memorialize this date? He said, well, I don't know. Maybe it would. I mean, like a guy who was new to the job, never gave a thought to it. And number two, which we talked about a little bit at length yesterday, was something else that he couldn't remember that now, of course, I'm drawing a blank on. When he was asked, I can't remember, but it was something very, again, something you would think would be very common sense. He would have to remember. And he, is it me or is this like the face of incompetence?
Steve, two points about this. Number one, reasons we were told not to worry about the fact that the Obama administration's Justice Department is flooded with lawyers who represented the enemy in wartime voluntarily. Was don't worry about it because they're going to recuse themselves from all those cases. Right. Now, they don't keep, as we're seeing now, their recusal policy leaves a lot to be desired. It seems a lot like Swiss cheese to me. Secondly, it seems to me that that this IRS thing and also the AP business where they've basically scorched the earth for the records of these reporters, the phone records, et cetera. What usually happens in the Justice Department is that it's the line assistants responsible for cases who are always pushing the envelope and wanting to scorch the earth and wanting to use all kinds of questionable tactics. And sometimes it's because they're young and they don't know any better. And that's the reason you're supposed to have adult supervision in the Justice Department. In other words, it's the Justice Department that's supposed to stop this sort of thing from happening. And here what we're seeing again and again is that it's the Justice Department where we don't have adult supervision. And for those of us who said it would be a tragic mistake for the country to confirm Eric Holder as Attorney General, I hate to say I told you so, but I told you so.
And of course, the president today, I'm sorry to interrupt, the president today said he has the utmost confidence in Eric Holder, which is something that George Steinbrenner used to say about Billy Martin every time right before he fired him, if you want to put it that way.
He's got the utmost confidence in the IRS, too, I'm sure.
Yeah, no, absolutely. All right, Andy, I appreciate your time. There's just so much we could go on and chat for, the rest of the show.
My tie, Steve? You appreciate my tie?
Very good, very good. I do appreciate your tie, but more so I appreciate your time, as always. The great friend to the show and my great friend, Andy McCarthy. Thank you, sir, so much.
Steve.
Take care. Andy McCarthy, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.